Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, today I'm going to talk about a very interesting topic. This video is going to be the start of a series on broadly neutralizing antibodies. I am going to attempt to explain 5 broadly neutralizing antibodies, and then I will talk about a clinical trial where a few of them are being deployed jointly and how it is progressing. Today we're going to talk about the PGDM 1400 BnAB, and we're going to discuss how it works, clinical trial status, and introduce the next BnAB that we will discuss in our next video. So that said, let's get started. Welcome back, friends. I want to start by showing you a graphic, and I'm going to describe all the BnABs that we are going to look at in this series. So let me line up the graphic now. So here you can see a schematic. I've taken it from the internet, and I have not made any of these. This is all from a report that I saw on the internet. So credits to those who made this. But what I want to talk about here is that you have the broadly neutralizing antibodies shown in this diagram. And you will see that we have at the very top PGDM 1400. And then as we move clockwise, we have PGT-121. That's what we're going to talk about next. And then we have 10E8 VLS. And then we have N6LS and VRC07, VRC01, and 3BNC117LS. So all of these are going to be discussed jointly. But I'm going to explain one BnAB at a time to keep it simple. So I think this series of videos will have a bunch, I think around 4 or 5 videos in this by the time we are done with it. And I want to keep it simple. So today we're going to talk about PGDM 1400. So to start with, let us first understand the geography of the target location for PGDM 1400. The target is the HIV trimer element. And in earlier videos, I was explaining more simplistically as the trimer is like a fork, and one of them is GP121. It goes and sticks to the CD4 receptor of the CD4 T cell, and then with the moment it gets in touch with the CCR5, there is conformational changes happening, and then GP121 dissolves, CCR5 dissolves, and GP41 is deployed, and which injects the RNA into CD4. So I had kept a very simplistic narrative, but right now we need to get into a more realistic description of the trimer. So the HIV envelope trimer is a more complex structure than just GP120 and GP41, as I have been simplistically explaining earlier. The HIV envelope is the entire spiky protein coat on the surface of HIV. It's made up of multiple spikes, and each of these spikes is made up of 3 identical subunits that come together to form the trimer. So in other words, there are lots of trimers all around the HIV virion. Each subunit of the trimer is itself a complex structure containing both GP120 and GP41. The GP120 region sits at the head of the subunit and is responsible for attaching to CD4 receptor on a T cell. So you can consider, mentally you can think of it as being at the tip of the spike of the HIV virus, of the trimer of the HIV virus. So if each trimer on the HIV virus is like a spike, then GP120 is at the tip of that spike. And then beneath this region is located the other protein, which is GP41. GP120 plays a crucial role in the fusion of HIV virus with the T cell membrane, allowing the virus to enter the cell. So the trimer isn't just individual GP120 and GP41 molecules. Each subunit is a combination of both, and 3 of these subunits come together to form the complete trimeric structure. So each HIV virion has got multiple trimers on its surface. Now let us talk about PGDM 1400 BnAB, which is capable of binding to this trimer. PGDM 1400 doesn't bind to the entire spiky ball, which is the envelope, but to a specific area, which is V1/V2 apex on the trimer of the ENV protein, or the envelope protein. By binding to the V1 or V2 apex, PGDM-1400 essentially blocks the doorknob that GP120 uses to latch onto the CD4 receptor on a CD4 T cell. This effectively prevents HIV from entering and infecting the healthy T cells. Research studies suggest that it was identified from a HIV-infected individual's immune response. This means scientists analyzed the antibodies produced by that person's immune system to fight HIV and isolated PGDM-1400 for its unique properties. So it was not developed in a lab, but it was isolated from the human body. So somebody's immune system manufactured or came up with this highly evolved, broadly neutralizing antibody in its fight against HIV. The natural form of PGDM-1400 was studied in phase 1 trials, and it's supposed to have a median elimination half-life of approximately 24 days in the human body. And here is what half-life means. Half-life refers to the time it takes for the amount of PGDM-1400 in the body to decrease by half. So if 100 units of PGDM-1400, for example, had been given to a patient, then at the end of 24 days, there will be 50 left. At the end of another 24 days, half of that 50 will be gone, so there will be another 25 left. And at the end of another 24 days, you will have around 12 and a half left, and so on. So that's how you have to understand the half-life of these broadly neutralizing antibodies. So this means that for PGDM-1400 to be effective, it might require frequent administration, like regular injections, to maintain sufficient levels of this in the body. However, there is a promising development. There is work going on PGDM-1400-LS. Researchers are working on a long-acting version of PGDM-1400 called PGDM-1400-LS, and this version is expected to have significantly extended half-life, potentially reducing the frequency of administration needed. And I'm trying personally to find status of that study, but I have not had much success so far at the time of recording this video, but I'm hopeful that I'll be able to find more details at a later stage. So this is just one of the BnAB's. There are other BnAB's also we're going to talk about in subsequent videos. And at the end of describing 5 or 6 or 7 of these BnAB's, I will then go and bring it all together with a clinical trial where multiple BnAB's are being studied together. PGT-121 is the other exciting BnAB that we are going to talk about, and that's going to happen in the next video. So please, in case you have not pressed the notify button, please press the notify button so that you do not miss that video. So if you see all of these in sequence, you'll be able to make sense of the final video, maybe the 6th or 7th video, where I'll bring it all together and talk about the clinical trial where all of them have been used together. So I would encourage you all to join the membership section or Patreon, as I'll discuss the therapies covered each month in an interactive manner in the monthly Zoom call. And besides, it will help the channel to become financially viable and stand on its own legs. We are now aiming to reach 20,000 subscribers, having completed 15,000 subscribers. So please subscribe if you have not already done so, and send a link of our channel to your friends and ask them to subscribe. And you'll be happy to know that most of our videos, all of our videos, now come with subtitles in almost 15 or 16 different languages, including Hindi. And the subtitles are included 24 to 48 hours after release of the video. This is because YouTube has some batch process through which it creates subtitles in English. And once the English subtitle is ready, then I have to go in and edit the subtitle to make sure that it's correct. And then I have to add all the languages in which I want it to do subtitles. So it takes a lot of time to finish that activity, not only for YouTube, but also for me to work after YouTube is done. So please be patient. If you don't see subtitles on day 1 or 2, it'll be there on day 3. Okay. So that said, that's all for now. I'll catch up with you in the next video. And I wish you all a very, very happy weekend, and I'll catch up with you next video. Bye for now.